So Melissa says, please talk more about limiting beliefs and give examples of positive statements. So limiting beliefs are things, so if you're not familiar, limiting beliefs are things that, beliefs that you have, right? They're usually statements or thoughts that you have about yourself, about the world around you, about life, about anything, right? About your capabilities, about what you deserve, right? So it could be that you feel or you believe that you don't really deserve a great man, or you believe that, you know, all men are pigs, or you believe that, you know, whatever. Whatever it is that you believe. And really what you want to do is just become aware of it. And the best way to become aware of your limiting beliefs is just to listen to yourself, because your limiting beliefs will come up, right, in different situations. And so whenever you put yourself into a specific situation, beliefs will come up. So if you get yourself into a situation with a guy, or you go out on a night in the town or whatever, right, you go on a date, and your thoughts will start coming up, right? Do I really deserve this guy? What, you know, he doesn't like me, you know, I'm too fat, I'm too short, I'm too tall, I'm too skinny, I'm too whatever, right? My hair is ugly, or my face is ugly, or whatever, right? So you have these different limiting beliefs that you have. And so what you want to do, and I mean, there's so many different positive statements that you can have. What you want to do is change those beliefs that you have. And the fastest way to do that is to create doubt. So all a belief is a statement about the world or yourself or life or whatever, that you have a lot of certainty, that you have a lot of belief, that you have a lot of confidence around, right? Or you have a lot of usually evidence, right? And so what you want to do is start questioning whether that belief is true or not, and find out what evidence that you have for that belief, and then start questioning whether that evidence actually creates your reality or the world, or whether it's just an example, or whether it's even true about that example that you do have. So let's take an example. Let's say that you believe that you're too old. Right, you believe that you're. Let's say you're 40 years old, and you believe you're too old to ever find a great man and fall in love and get married again, which is something that I hear from women in our community all the time. And so, one of the things that you might look at is, you know, start questioning it and say, is it really true that I'm too old? And one of the things that you might first come up with is, yeah, it is really true. And so you might want to say, yeah, but is it really true, right? Like, I actually got this from Byron Katie. She has a great system. It's called The Work. And what she does is she questions limiting beliefs. And so what you do is you just say, yeah, is this really all that true that I can't? And so, you know, if you really sit there and think about it, you might start to realize that it's not true. And if you can't really realize that, what you might want to do is start looking for evidence that it's not true, right? So I have a program or a live stream that I did that's called Why Men Love Older Women. And in that live stream, there are, I don't know how many women, probably dozens and dozens of women in that live stream who talk about how they're dating men who are 3, 5, 10, 15, even 20 years younger than they are. And so, you know, when you look at that live stream, you watch that live stream and you read the comments from all these women, you can start to see that there's evidence out there of these women who are dating men who are much younger than them, and they're in their 40s, 50s, 60s, right? And so it's definitely, it starts to create doubt, right? Once you start to see evidence that it is possible that you could have a relationship even though you're 40 years old and you're not too old, all of a sudden it creates doubt around the belief that you have.